What's up everyone? So I recently had some issues with one of my hard drives. This is not just for the hard drives, it also supports SSDs and stuff, and this is one of the best tools for repairing actual bad sectors. It doesn't just hide them, but it actually repairs them. Let's check their website first. So that's the official website, and I can tell you already without even showing you the tool that I have been using this ever since it was first released. I don't think it was released in 2011. I think it's been out there a little bit, you know, before that. But anyway, I've been using this for a very long time, and I can tell you it really does work. It's one of the best tools, if not the best tools, for repairing hard drives. It's just amazing. There is a free trial available if you want to test it out. One of the hard drives that has issues, let me just check, it was smart, I believe. Here we go. This shows the stats of all of my drives, and as you can see in here, I have 3x2TB drives, and that's why I'm not using SSDs, because that's a little bit too expensive for me at the moment, but anyway. As you can see in here, it has some current pending sector count, which refers to bad sectors. This one in here, I'm actually not sure what this is. I mean, I know what this means. That has something to do with communication between the drive and the computer, but like bad cable or something. But I know I have no bad cables, so not sure what the hell this is. Anyway, my primary drive works fine, but these are the two problematic ones, and as you can see, they have something wrong in here. But anyway, a lot of people say that you should instantly replace the hard drive if you have any bad sectors, but this is as stupid as saying that if your car has a broken headlight, then you should instantly buy a new car. Like, things like this happen. It highly depends how many bad sectors you have and if it keeps, you know, going up or not. As you can see, even this says it's okay, so that's fine. Anyway, let's start with this. Let's click in here. Okay, that's nothing important in here. I don't even know why it says that. I checked it long ago and whatever, it doesn't matter. Okay, so you can choose the hard drive, whichever one you want to scan. I could actually... wait, which one is... Okay, that's my games drive. Yeah, let's try this one. That's where my games are. Remote control, it supports remote control now, so let's try this one. And then we do, what is this, extra modes? Okay, data destructive, you don't want to do that, so, and yeah, this doesn't cause you to lose anything at all, so you don't actually have to back up your drive. So let's do a normal scan then, with or without repairs, so, yeah, let's do that. And this is a really bad option, don't choose this one, but if you have a smaller drive, you might actually do that. You should just do this one, scan and repair, and you can also resume last process, or you can set the sectors manually. For example, if you have a ran this on another computer, or if someone like tested your hard drive, I'll just start from here and then I'll explain, and someone tells you that yeah, you have like from sector this, you know, then you can go to that other option and input that sector mode manually, whichever sector you want, and then it can start from there. Or if you want to like you know, resume this process on another computer, let's say if you're doing small, you know, computer repairs and you have this tool on more than one computer and the drives are like USB drives or something, then that's also very useful. You just write down where it left off, and on another PC you can restart the process. So, but this process takes quite long. Like, it depends on your drive capabilities, but as you can see the percentage in here, mine is a 2TB drive, and it's also a slow speed hard drive. It's only 5400 RPM, and there's a reason for that, because I like to have more, you know, durability over speed and performance. So I rather have like a slower car that gets me from A to B every single time 100%, rather than having a Ferrari that just burns down when you just park it next to like a coffee shop or something, you know. This is something I don't like. So, but it depends highly how long it takes. It can take anywhere between like, let's say, few minutes up to few days. And it also highly depends on how many bad sectors there are. If the drive is healthy and if a high speed drive, then it just goes in, you know, a few minutes or something. But as you can see in here, estimated is almost 4 hours in here. And well, I'm gonna let it run a little bit and then I'll come back to it and see if it has actually found anything. Well, just for the sake of it, I'm just running it on my SSD right now, the primary one. However, I should have shown you this process, but anyway, it just told me that the exclusive access cannot be obtained because obviously the drive is, you know, mounted. It dismounts the drive and then it can scan the entire thing. But anyway, on SSD, as you can see, the speed is a lot faster and it should be able to detect all the bad sectors, although it might not be able to repair them. However, I don't think there are any bad sectors on my SSD. That's quite new one. So as you can see in here, it estimates it only takes 11 minutes. So it highly depends on the drive capabilities and of course on the size and also how much data you have on it. And in meanwhile, while it's doing its thing, I wanted to mention one really, really good feature is the bootable regenerating flash drive. You can make it from here and then create bootable flash. It's grayed out because I'm using it right now, the tool. But this is very, very good thing. For example, let's say your computer has generated some bad sectors on your primary drive, so you can't even boot it up or it just hangs, you know. I mean, bad sectors doesn't necessarily cause a crash. It just causes, you know, extreme lag. And if it's, you know, important Windows files, then it can just get stuck on the, you know, the booting sequence for like hours, you know. And this is where you make the bootable flash drive. You boot into that and then you run it from that drive and you can scan your primary drive and repair the sector. So I think this is very important feature and that's why I wanted to mention it. Well, no surprise here, no bad sectors on this one. That was quite fast. So let's check the process on this one. See, it has found one bad sector and it says one bad sector's recovered already. Sector, it should have a dash, but whatever. Speed is actually pretty good for a hard drive. That's actually pretty good indeed. Didn't expect it to be that good, but yeah, as you can see, it does work. See, it found another bad sector, so let's see if it repairs that. Yeah, current write, see, that's why it's so slow in there. Yeah, and it did repair that. Yeah, and that's what bad sectors can do to your, you know, PC. It can make it extremely slow. I mean, look at the write speed right now. And this is not a reason to, you know, get yourself a new drive or anything. If it's really, really, you know, small amount of them, then it really doesn't matter. One sector, I believe, is 512 bytes or something. So that's almost nothing, you know. So if you have like, I don't know, 10, 20 megabytes of bad sectors on a 2 terabyte drive, then there is absolutely no reason to panic at all. However, it can corrupt some data, so that's the only problem, you know. It can corrupt something and you just can't recover it. But other than that, this tool works miracles. It's a really good tool. I have used this on old hard drives and it just does work. It really does repair the stuff. However, it's not going to make the hard drive obviously new, so the speed's going to be still a little bit reduced, but it's going to do its job. It's going to repair your data and most likely you can still use the drive, you know, pretty decently. And before I end this video, here is also a few words about it, how it works. You can just read it in here. So it doesn't just, you know, hide the bad sectors, but it actually, you know, regenerates them. It's different on SSD. I'm not entirely sure how it works on SSDs, but SSDs can also have so-called bad sectors where the data, you know, cannot be read. But on SSDs, it usually means that it's gone. So that's why the SSD capacity over time just decreases. Anyway, read it through if you want. They tell you what's it about, how it works. And I think I'm going to leave it in here because it really does take a long time. Unfortunately, I don't have a small enough disk that with bad sectors to show you the difference, like before regenerating and after regenerating. I'd really like to make this test, but unfortunately, I just don't have any hardware. And bad sectors are not something I can just replicate, you know, so Well, I can tell you this tool really does work. It's a great tool, so if you're looking for one, this is definitely the one to go to. So I hope this video is useful. I hope you get your drive repaired with this, and well, see you later.